So this is the last lecture about the NPTEL and SWAMI courses. There are two things he will explain to us. Dr. Satyen Singh from Department of Computer Science and Engineering.
I will keep it short. So, you must be getting emails from Deshi for to the courses from SWAMI now. So there are lots of MOOC platforms, SWAMI, Coursera, EDX, Udacity, and Academy. So we'll focus on SWAMI because it's an Indian version of MOOC from MHRD. So we'll see briefly SWAMI for faculty, SWAMI for students, how student can be benefited from it, and course development for SWAMI. So basically in MOOC there are four types of learning. E-learning, when you just like you are creating document on a smart board or on a computer, you are creating a PPT and sharing to students, and this is called e-learning. So web-based learning, when you are delivering a lecture or you are sending a recorded video through web browsers, students are learning through web browser, then it is called web-based learning. And it is quite divided into synchronous and asynchronous. Like, so the lecture that is live broadcasted is synchronous, where audience is live and instructor is live. Asynchronous, when there is a recorded lecture, just like SWAMI or NPTEL, when you see the lectures and you attend those lectures and do learning. So basically, SWAMI and this type of learning is come under asynchronous learning. So MOOC generally provides massive open online courses. Massive, there are lots of students can register. It is open anywhere, anybody can register online, and there are lots of courses in MOOC. So basically what MHRD did, so you already know NPTEL and other platform where you can see the videos and learn. What MHRD did, it created an umbrella over all these different coordinators of like NPTEL is a project of IITs. So it created an umbrella where you can learn, you can give the examination, and you can get the certificate. So it's kind of formal learning through SWAMI. All the courses that are available on NPTEL are available on SWAMI. If you want to just get an informal learning, you go to NPTEL directly and you can see the lectures. On SWAMI, if you want to learn and you want to get the certificate and you want to give the examination, you can go to the SWAMI and register it. So I'll skip that. So these are the national coordinators for technical education. We have NPTEL for non-technical degrees. UGC is there for school education, NCERT, and for teachers training, NIDTR. So these are the coordinators that manage all the resources for the SWAMI. Generally, the courses that we took for the technical education comes from the NPTEL. Now, you must have seen this SWAMI portal where there is a course. So you can sign up or register through your email ID or institute ID or even normal Gmail ID. You can register it. And after registering and selecting a course, you can select the course from this course catalog, and you can select from your discipline. And the courses that you have registered will show here with your progress, that how much you have completed. So this is not the important part. The important part is, see, from morning we have learned different tools for taking online lectures and different tools to manage students, give the assignments. So how we can use these online courses for our in blended learning with our teaching. So we are going to teach some subjects in next semester. So what we can do, we can identify some courses from SWAMI that are very similar to our course that we are going to teach. And what we can do, we can ask the student to register those courses. The registration is totally free. There is no cost involved in the registration. Even giving the assignments and giving the exams, the quizzes, the normal in between the courses are there, these are absolutely free. Only for the certification you have to pay and give the last exam. So what we can do, we can tell our student, okay, so I'm going to teach this subject. A similar type of subject is this, which have maximum similar content or syllabus. you ask your student to register this courses. Now how we can be benefited from these courses? After completing a particular topic, we generally take quizzes for students. In normal offline classes, we take a surprise quiz, or we generally take some questions to do the answers. What we can ask students to do, give the quiz after a particular topic on the Swayam that he has registered. You can ask the student their marks in terms of a screenshot and all. Whatever marks they get an assignment, you can use these marks as a continuous evaluation. Normally we do the internal marks that we generally give to the student out of 20, out of 30 that we can decide. So we can ask our student to give those assignments in the MOOC in the Swayam platform, and they are very good actually. So what we are getting, we are getting continuous evaluation of the student parallel to our course. Now these are some of the courses that are open currently. So our management side, so is there anyone from management side? So PC, these are the courses that currently are open. And for MME, these are the courses. हाँ स्वयं स्वयं पे अभी करंटली किसका कोर्सेरा का एक्सटेंड कर दिया है. सो इट इज एक्सटेंडेड अप टू 31 सितंबर. सो इट्स फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट, यू कैन रजिस्टर फॉर कोर्सेरा आल्सो. इट इज एक्सटेंडेड नाउ आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ आवर कोर्स, द कोर्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टेक इन नेक्स्ट सेमेस्टर. वॉलंटरली स्टूडेंट कैन गिव द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ स्वयं कोर्स, एंड इफ ही गेट द सर्टिफिकेट, इफ ही पास, TechU will reimburse the fees, which is normal. I think 700 to 1000 will be the fees. So TechU will reimburse the fees. So student का कोई cost नहीं. We are getting benefited that continuous learning की हो रही है student के साथ में, and they are earning some extra credits. So this way we can use that these online courses in our teaching as a blended learning. हाँ, ये मैं share कर दूँगा जरूर. So I think this
is.
हाँ, और ये भी अभी छोटी लिस्ट है, मतलब मैंने जस्ट कुछ सिलेक्ट करके डाले हैं. देन अदर्स. ओके, सो ये शेयर नहीं होता अभी, वो कलर क्यों नहीं था. ठीक है, तो थ्रू स्वयं फॉर स्टूडेंट एंड फैकल्टी देयर इज इनफॉर्मल लर्निंग. You can just register with Swayam course, you can identify, enroll, learn at your own pace, get certification, if get clarification, online discussion, submit your assignment, complete your course. That's it. If you want to for formal learning, complete your course, register for exam, pay online. Write exam, get certificate. If you get the certificate, just ask TechU to reimburse the fees. TechU will give you the fees and get the credit transfer. For a student, UGC has recommended that credit up to 20% can be transferred. So the 20% credit that he has got from the Swayam platform can be transferred into BTEC credits. So for example, BTEC credits have 192 credits that he or she has to earn for the BTEC degree. 20% credit can be earned from the Swayam platform, and it can be transferred to the course. So, okay. Now, what is for the teachers, faculties? So, one way, one that we have already discussed, that we can get the benefit of blended learning. We can ask the student to register. Also, we can also create courses for Swayam. We can globalize our teaching, and there is another career advancement scheme through ARPIT. So ARPIT is a scheme called Annual Refresher Program in Teaching. So there are some programs that annually comes on the Swayam for the teachers only. Teachers can register and complete the course at not in MNIT right now, but in other institute it is accepted as a API school, ARPIT. So maybe in future there will be a case for here in MNIT also. So One is RPA and now if you want to develop a course, there are four quadrant in SWAM. Quadrant one is e-tutorial, e-content, discussion forum, and assessment. You have to create your content in that. So normally what we do and when we are teaching in a normal classroom, we just prepare for the next lecture. We have to give the lecture in the next lecture, and then after that we think for the other lectures. For preparing a course material for SWAM or other MOOC platform, you have to completely design your whole 40 modules at least for 4 credit. So suppose you are going to propose a 4 credit course, then you have to at least prepare 40 modules or 40 lectures that you can see. In MOOC platform or in online teaching, it is called modules. So you have to create 40 modules, and each module can have 30 minutes of video. So at least you have to create 20 hours of video lectures for 4 credit, and you can divide for 1 credit into 1. So at least 8 to 10 module for 1 credit, and you can offer non-credit courses also. Then a weekly template plan is look like this of all the MOOC courses. Every week there are some videos and some lectures and textual material that you give to the students. Some assignments are there, and discussion forum is there for weekly, and some assessment through quizzes or peer learning. That I've told you earlier that we can use this assignment as a continual learning for our students also. So, okay, so for faculty part, if you want to develop a course on SWAM, you can send a proposal. So what path follow? You submit the proposal approved by NC. NC means National Coordinator. So we are technical. Education. So we have to submit it for the to the NPTEL. So NPTEL. NPTEL. NPTEL chapter United mein nahi hai. So NPTEL time to time. Template gives an advertisement for EOI, expression of interest. So through that expression of interest, you can submit your proposal. So normally, submit your proposal. It is approved by a national coordinator for technical interest NPTEL. You produce your course content, whether it is for 4 credit, 2 credits, or 1 credit, depending on that. You produce the content, teach online, you conduct assessment, you discuss, progress review, and grade student and finish the course. So normally the process begins with announcement of expression of interest from the national coordinator, and it comes in the newspaper and the online also, and sometimes we get the mail from registrar and registrar for this. And there is a recently one call for all the courses have to transfer it into regional languages through NPTEL. For example, हमारे पास कोई course है उसका regional language में पूरा उसको transfer करना है. Sir, expression of interest भी आया था बीच में. So there are multiple UIs advertised through the NPTEL. Time to time.
मतलब वीडियो रिकॉर्ड होती नहीं फिर
अपलोड किए जाते हैं. हाँ, asynchronous. It is asynchronous. Yes. It is all comes under the asynchronous.
और next year suppose same course अगर अपलोड करता है, suppose I am uploading a course, same course next year अपलोड करता है, same content कैसे अपलोड again?
If NC permits. You can do. So there are lots of courses that are regularly being floated with some minor modification to the current scenario. So what you have to give? You have to give course brief overview, course title overview, mode of instruction, course duration. आपको कितना होगा? Whether it is a new course or repurposed from the existing program. That we just mentioned. Type of certification, whether it is a credit course, non-credit course, or is just a simple awareness program. So 1 to 4 credit course is expected to cover in 4 to 12 week of duration. So if it is a 4 credit course, you have to cover it in 12 weeks. So then, depending on the type of credit, there are different courses on the SWAM. Of different duration. You have to explain broad objective of the course. you have to specify learning outcome with each module. Each big module you have to specify your learning outcome, and you have to give a 2-5 minute introductory video where course coordinator tells about the course objectives, learning outcomes, and prerequisite, and the course information. And teaching team can have multiple teams. Learner minimum qualification. If you want to attend particular course, what could be the minimum qualification of the learner or student? And prerequisite of the courses and duration of the course, how much it will be. So you have to submit video lecture, reading material, self assessment. So for that you have to, you may have 40 videos of half an hour, that is 20 hours you have to complete. Evaluation methodology, you can decide how you evaluate your student on Swayam portal. That is for register, like MNIT we have 50, 30, 20. You can decide your own how it could be done. And allocation of marks to various assessment, like what would be the marks for assignment, practical, project work, and final exam. Now, the current problem with the Swayam is that the completion rate is very less. So TechEd is sending you mails to register the courses, and we register the courses, but eventually we did not complete it mostly. So completion rate is still very less. So to increase it, what we can do, we can use these courses as a blended learning with our online courses. Then we can increase the completion rate. There is a chance. Only courses are there, not full curriculum. Only 20 credit can transfer right now to Swayam. A BTEC student can transfer only 20 credits. And proctored exam for masses. So if you want to take exam for thousands of students, how the examination will take place. So currently, if you register for NPTEL, you have seen there is an examination center in the city, and you go there and you give the examination for the certificate. So, okay, so that part was on the content creation. So I'll go to one particular slide. I think content creation was well. So, already मैं हाँ उन्होंने बता दिया तो मैं इसलिए भी बता रहा हूँ. मैं जस्ट डायरेक्टली एक ही स्लाइड देखो लास्ट में. तो इफ यू वांट टू क्रिएट इनफॉर्मल वीडियोस ऑफ योर लेक्चर यू कैन यूज दिस टूल. इफ यू वांट टू जस्ट यूज ऑडियो नरेशन यू कैन यूज अदर टूल. स्क्रीन कास्टिंग, सो आई यूज स्क्रीन रिकॉर्डर फॉर यूट्यूब लेक्चर. आई क्रिएटेड सम यूट्यूब लेक्चर लास्ट सेमेस्टर एंड अपलोडेड ऑन यूट्यूब फॉर स्टूडेंट्स. सो यू कैन यूज दिस, दिस ऑल्सो फ्री. But with this, there will be a watermark of screencast-o-matic. So you can use this to create your informal video lectures. Okay, so we'll stop here.
Okay, thank you very much for the very informative talk on NPTEL and CERT. Now,
for any course, you can
this is the last presentation. So the presentation is over now. So let's thank the speaker. So tomorrow schedule is again tomorrow we'll meet at 9 a.m. for the two different branches. I think mechanical engineering and one more branch, I forgot. So now we are ending this today's session, and online participant, thank you for joining us. I am closing the link. Thank you.